Okay, yes. So now the moment we say that there is a line that has to be drawn, we give the inputs for the line, whether it has to be a straight line, length, horizontal or not. And we are able to see that line to be drawn onto the, which has been displayed onto the screen. Now, how does this happen actually? So the system actually doesn't understand what is a line. Okay, it takes the input. Yes, it gives, it solves it in the CPU, and suitable signals are going to be given out through the to the display. Okay, and we are able to see a line. But what happens over here is that now this graphics devices, one is that these devices have to convert this output signals into such that only that particular pixels are going to be changed to draw the line, whether it has to be black color or whatever it is. Next thing is that what is a line, the system doesn't understand. So what is a line, what is a circle? If such an input command is being received, then how should it give out the output onto the display, right? So what is a line, what is a circle, right? All these definitions having a set of instructions written in the form of a program where the computer can understand will be stored in a library file. Okay, will be stored in a library file. Okay, that is the graphics library. So as I told you, if you remember in C programming, when we want to write a program to add two numbers, in the first line, we always write include hash std io.h. That means include the standard library files to run the C programming. Next line, since the program, in the program, we are going to use to add two numbers, we will also add the second line as include math io.h. Okay, that means we are calling in this library function. We need the mathematical related files to run this program, right? And after that, we write the C programming where we are going to use two numbers and we'll add plus sign. The moment the, and once we execute this program, the moment this program is going to read this line, first number plus second number, the moment it is going to read this word plus or the symbol plus, okay, what it is going to do, it is immediately going to go to the mathematical file and read what is this plus indicate. Over there, it would have been written, what is this plus? Addition. It can be addition of two numbers, three numbers, or four numbers. So that set of programs, it is going to run in the background, and we are going to get the output onto the screen. So that is a library file. So similarly over here, for displaying of images and all those things, there's a separate graphics file, which will have what is a line, arc, circle, and so many other things. So that will all those programs will be stored in a particular file, which is called as the library files. Okay. Now, where can we see this? If we install any software, sometimes when it is little bit slowly installing, we will see that it is installing the software. Then it will say, we can see in the installation process, we can see it is uploading the library files. So that library file will come along with the package generally. With which package? I took up this example of this graphics card. So the moment we buy a graphics card, it is going to come with the hardware. Along with that, there's one CD. In the CD, it is going to have programs related to run this graphics card. Plus, it is also going to have the library files to run this program. Both the things will be there, okay? So once we install this, the library files and the graphics device files, both will be installed, right? So both are required over here. That is what is actually mentioned over here. There will be graphics, okay? So graphics software is divided into two groups. One is the device drivers and other one is the graphics libraries. So device drivers are nothing but programs written to drive to run this graphics card. And the libraries are the set of functions which is also there. So device drivers is one file, graphic library is another file. Without both of this graphic software will never work at all. So I've just taken for our easy understanding the case of a separate graphics card that we use for the CPU desktops, right? So this is one use. Okay, this is how any graphics software will run. One of the example is a graphics card. So without a graphics card, usually it is inbuilt. So usually when it is inbuilt, what will happen is it'll always have the set of hardware already mounted onto the motherboard itself. So the motherboard CD will carry all these files itself. So when you install this will get, that is the driver files and the library files will get activated. And this, when are we going to do this? We are going to install this motherboard CD after we install the operating system files. So the operating system files, that is the Windows XP or 7 or 8. After that, we are going to add these additional applications files, which is going to embed with this Windows files or operating system files. Okay, so now coming to this graphics device and graphics libraries. So as I explained over here, this is only with regarding to the driver input. The user is going to give the input, okay? And it is going to get processed because we are going to give this input using suitable application program. And this driver is going to make suitable changes and give it out as the output onto our display system. So basically we need an application program first to run. Then whatever we are going to make use of this application program, the outputs of that will be going to this driver. Okay, that is, it can be an input graphics generally in the motherboard itself or a separate graphics card. And then the outputs of the driver will be seen onto the output devices, that is our monitor. Okay, but for this, what we need, the graphics library is much more important. That is why this graphics library is coming in between this application program and driver, in between both of them. Why? Because the graphics library is very much helpful, because without that, the purpose of the driver is not at all solved. If we say line, circle, arc and all, the driver may not be able to understand because it doesn't know what is a line or arc and how it has to be projected, in which angle the electron beam has to be hitting onto that particular pixel. It doesn't know, because it doesn't know what is the meaning of line, arc, circle. So where does it get it from? It gets it from the graphics library. If we don't write this default application separately, then for every time the user has to write the program, which is a very, very tedious process. So thereby only almost all the basic functions will be set up as a library file in every software. In every software, it will be there. Right? So that is related to the graphics, how the graphics library and devices are important. So I'll take up another example. When we go up with when we want to watch any online video, sometimes we will get an error saying that Adobe Flash Player is not updated. So thereby the video cannot be displayed. So we'll get such an error. Adobe Flash Player is not updated, video error, and so on things when we are watching online video sometimes. So why this is happening is that video is actually running on the platform of Adobe Flash Player, which is a graphic software. So without that installed onto our viewing system, let it be a desktop or a laptop, without that, the video will not be displayed because it cannot process, even though the signals are received from the internet. Since it is an online video, even though the system has received that signals, okay, and it has been processed also, it cannot display it onto the screen because we don't have that particular graphic software installed at all. So unless and until we install, we cannot do that. So this is the need of graphics libraries, okay, right?